talk about the latest development, cataract surgery, which has enabled us to give a more predictable and better outcome in all cataract surgeries. That is the femtosecond laser, which was in vogue, which was launched in 2010 for refractive surgery, has been now used for cataract surgery. And as we all know, cataract surgery is soon becoming a refractive procedure. That is, most of the patients after cataract surgery don't want to wear glasses. They go in for a multifocal lens or an accommodative lens. So the results of the cataract surgery, which were initially unpredictable, have to be more predictable, and you are opting for earlier cataract surgery only because we are able to give more predictable outcomes. Now with the femtosecond laser added to our armamentarium, I'll go on to explain how it will give a very predictable and a safe outcome. So laser, I just run through it. Laser refractive cataract surgery is the name coined by us. We have the first and the only installation of the laser cataract machine, the femtosecond Victus machine, in the entire Asia at Hyderabad exhibition. I was privileged enough to go and operate over there and a hands-on experience. And being the first surgeon in Chennai, I think I can rightfully tell how the femtosecond laser is going to alter the entire scenario of cataract surgery in the future. It helps us in capsulotomy, lens fragmentation, and as well as placing incisions. What is very important is the capsulotomy, which till now has been a surgeon-dependent technique. Hence, the outcomes are not as predictable. The skilled surgeon will definitely have more predictable outcomes. However, a beginner or a fresh new surgeon may not have such predictable outcomes in capsulotomy. Next slide. Here, I like to show you a surgery done by my chief and my mentor and guide, Dr. K.P. Reddy in Hyderabad. This was an intumescent cataract. It's an advanced cataract. As you can see, the nucleus is almost bulging. We have stained the capsule blue color so you can have a better view. Even a skilled and a very senior surgeon's hand, doing a capsulotomy is very difficult. As you can see, there's so much of pressure fluctuation in the eye, and the cataract, which is intumescent, seems to be leaking, so you can't have a good circular access in these cases. Next slide. So what happens then? Then we came up with this Victus femtosecond laser platform. This femtosecond machine was involved from 2010. It is primarily used to raise a corneal flap during refractive LASIK surgery. However, we use the same machine, the same femtosecond laser. We put in a real-time OCT, and real-time OCT is like a CT scan. It gives us a cross-sectional analysis of the entire eye. During surgery, we'll be able to see the eye like this. This is the cornea, and this is the cataract. So we'll be able to use the real-time OCT-guided femtosecond laser to create a capsulotomy, which is with the help of this docking station. I'll show you the subsequent slides. And we are able to fragment the nucleus, crack the nucleus in multiple pieces. Next slide. So this is the docking platform which we have. And this is the intelligent pressure sensor guide, which is very important. It is all computer control. All the surgeons got to do is just position this dock, just gently touch it on the patient's eye. That's about it. So nothing else he's got. There's no other role of a surgeon there. This is not done in a sterile operation theater. This is done outside the sterile OT in a separate femtosecond laser room. Here you can see the surgeon is not scrubbed. He has to put this special pressure, the docking platform, onto the patient's eye and gently dock this platform onto the cornea. That's all he's got to do. Nothing else the surgeon's got to do. Next slide. Following this is how it will look once docked. Here you can see a circular rexus which is being done by the femtosecond laser. It is real-time OCT image guided and computer controlled. So we have an exact circular rexus. If you want a 5mm or 6mm, we'll be able to give it. The computer will be able to monitor the centration of the rexus as well as the circularity of the rexus. Next slide. So this is how the rexus would look like at the end of the surgery. This is a 6mm rexus which we have done. And you see how easy it is to remove the rexus. You have to just go on with the MacPherson or Optata forceps and just nudge it, tweeze it out of the eye. Similarly, in this case, here you can see with just a very minimal aspiration, you are able to pull off the rexus from the eye. Next slide. So the main advantage is here you can see the rexus is almost circular, centered. Why we need such a centered and circular rexus? Why didn't we need it earlier? Because now we are operating with a lot of premium IOLs. We are going in for patients who are much younger, who want to have spectacle-free vision even after cataract surgery. When you go for an accommodative IOL, you need an exactly 5 mm rexus in all radial quadrants, and it has to be centered. So that kind of precision, even the best of surgeons are not able to get. So that's when this laser comes to play for the premium IOLs. So this is a study which we did, and we found that the femto, the amount of decentration in the femto rexus was much far less than half of the mandible rexus. Again, the other parameters, we also use the laser to fragment the nucleus. Here you see, normally earlier we are using the chopper and the take energy power to fragment, chop the nucleus. However, with the help of the laser, we are able to divide and crack the nucleus into multiple quadrants. And we can also, like I showed you, this is the rectus which is being done first. Then we followed with the radial cuts, it's like a cross. The main advantage of this is it's a very fast procedure. It will take only around 20 to 30 seconds. Once this cuts and the rexus is made, we immediately peel out the patient out of the femtosecond laser room and send him to the steroid OT and start the surgery. Next slide. And we also tried different kind of strategies, different kind of cuts, the lens fragmentation. We tried something called a pizza cut, which are again like pie type cuts after following rexus. This is how you will get the pizza cuts. And the main advantage of this is the take is much easier following these kind of pizza cuts, because you can then remove the nucleus fragment wise from different quadrants. Next slide, please. So I'm just trying to show the how versatile the machine is. You can go in for any type of cuts. You can go for a 4 radial cuts. You can go for a 4 radial cuts with a circular cuts. As per the surgeon's wish, it's all computer controlled. He has to just go. It's got a touch screen. He has to just go find out. Okay, I want this kind of cut. Once he docks the femtosecond laser onto the eye, everything the laser takes care of. Next slide. So I just like to show a small video which shows how easy to extract the capsule. Normally we don't stain the capsule, however here we stained it for the video purpose to show how easy it is to extract the capsule which has been created by the femtosecond laser. Here you can see the radial cut, which is the nuclear fragmentation. We inject an air bubble so that the dye does not stain the cornea. Here you can see the surgeon is trying to see already when he injected the visco or the ocular viscosurgical device. You can see the capsule already separating from the nucleus. It's already being separated. It's as simple as this. He just injects the viscoelastic and he's able to gradually shear the capsule from the rest of the remnant. It's as simple as that. You can even use the forceps like what I said earlier, but this is more gradual and a more guarded procedure. And the take is again very easy. This is again in fast time motion. The take is very simple because already you have pre-existing cuts. So the surgeon has got to just go and separate the nucleus like this. The amount of take energy required during this cataract is also very less. And as a result of which, the outcomes are much more predictable. We have pristine clear corneas on the first post-operative day. And any patient who is thinking of going for a premium cataract surgery, that is, who wants to have a spectacle-free vision post-op, can definitely opt for a femtosecond laser-based cataract surgery. Entire time of the cataract surgery has come down drastically from 10 to 15 minutes to 5 minutes with this procedure. So what are the complications? The most challenging part of manual cataract surgery, as I pointed out, is this rexus, which you have seen here in the best of hands, you will have unpredictable outcomes. So when you're doing most of the surgeries in topical anesthesia. So when you're doing it in topical anesthesia, due to high saccadic movements, you will not be able to control the rexus. With the help of femtosecond, you have more predictable rexus and better outcome. So I like to conclude by saying that Victor's platform is very versatile with cataract and refractive. You can do an elastic with that. My colleague will be talking to you on that. And it will also help us giving a much better experience to the patients who come with a surgery for premium cataract surgery. And more importantly, we are using right now this for capsulotomy and neutral lens fragmentation. Soon we'll be using it for corneal incisions, so we'll be able to do astigmatic keratotomy as well after surgery, as a result of which we can guarantee patient will recover.